Hi folks, this is your host Mandeep, and and I'm going to do another tutorial today where we're going to look at an interesting indicator that is being talked about quite a bit on Twitter by the financial community, and it's called the DeMarc sequence indicator, which on Thinkorswim goes by the name of the sequence counter. So there's clearly a ton of math involved in it, and you know, for those who are technically inclined and want to totally understand how this works, they can kind of go through this. It's not very hard, but basically there's two things that we care about. We care about the buy formations, and the reverse of that is the sell formation, and in addition we have a buy array and a sell array, right? So this buy formation is formed when if the stock is moving up, the close is greater than, you know, close from four bars ago, right? And it has to be sequential, right? And this stops when it hits the number 9. And then once this ends, you actually start forming what is called a buy array or a sell array, where, you know, the close has to be greater than or equal to the high of the two bars ago. And so this sequence, the buy formation sequence, will stop at number 9, and this has to be consecutive, and I'll show you a couple examples. And if the sequence breaks for whatever reason in the middle, then it'll stop and then restart again, right? But when it comes to the buy array formation, this will, you know, go on. Even if the sequence breaks, it will find the next opportunity where the close is greater than, you know, the high of two bars ago. And those numbers will sort of keep incrementing and stop at 13. And when it hits 13, it basically means sort of a topping formation or an exhaustion that has happened. Clearly doesn't mean it'll always work that way, because that's not how things always work out, but at least it gives you a pause, right? It gives you a little bit of a you know, a moment to think whether you should be maybe, you know, trimming your long positions here, and then, you know, if things really start to move in the opposite direction, then you can remove the rest of the stuff off. So anyway, so basically what you need to install is this indicator called the sequence indicator, which is which comes standard with Thinkorswim, and this is the replacement, or this is renamed or called you know, sequence indicator, but it is the same thing as the DeMarc sequence, right? In addition to that, I was just perusing the net, and I found some code which somebody had written, which obviously is available in a public domain, right? So they talk about how to create an alert when you hit the buy formation and a sell formation. And I just extended that a little bit to include both the formations, where you have the sequence of 9 and the sequence of 13. When that happens, it gives you a little chime telling you, you know, this is meeting that criteria. And I'll put a description, put it in the description from where you can download this, or, you know, I'll give you guys a link. Anyway, so once you actually install these two, you essentially will start seeing numbers like this, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. And, you know, as I said, the buy formation goes all the way to 9, right? And the buy formation gets formed when, this will begin when the close on this bar is higher than 4 bars ago. So, you know, you just have to count backwards, 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? So it's higher. So you got the sequence 1 started, same with 2, right? You just go back 4 bars, and at 9 it'll basically stop, right? So a lot of people use this as a reversal indicator, and in some cases it really works out to perfection, as you can see in case of SPY. This is where, you know, the market topped around 338.30, right? That's close to the highest point, and you know, the 9 sequence completed. Right now, of course, we didn't get to 13 in this case, but now when we look at it again, right, the market went down whatever, about 34%, and now has corrected significantly, right? We've almost gained you know, halfway back, and what people are talking about is now we've hit this number 13, right? So this is really the array formation that gets formed, right? When the array formation gets to 13, it usually signifies some kind of an exhaustion, right? Whether it's temporary or permanent, we don't know. It doesn't mean for sure the market's going to reverse and start to go down. But for me, it's given me a moment of pause. And what I've done really is, I've positioned myself a little bit more defensively here. In other words, I've basically gains I had in the last couple of weeks, I've booked them, and now I'm left with a few positions which are also hedged now through, SPY puts, as well as some VIX calls that I have. So this is worth sort of keeping an eye on, right? So what happens here, right? As I said, there's no guarantee. We could start another sequence that keeps going up. We'll look at a couple other examples, and hopefully that'll gives you a little bit of a better sense. Now, in case of the Qs, what you'll see that in the back in Feb, right, when we hit the all-time high, we also hit the array formation at 13, right, which is basically the point where the current trend is exhausted. So from there on, right, we of course it doesn't mean that right from the next bar market starts to fall, but you clearly had a couple more days, and after that the market took a dive, right? But interestingly, what you can also see at the bottom, right, and this is that perfect buy formation where the sequence only goes up to 9. We hit number 9, and at that time, at that point, basically the market bottomed, and from there, it has gone up. But what we see is that this number 13 is now again showing up here as well, and this has happened yesterday. And basically same thing. It just gives you a little bit of a pause, and you may want to either trim your positions or at least be a little bit cognizant that the market could reverse here, but only time will tell how things go, right? So this is like being talked quite a bit on Twitter within the financial community, and I thought I'll share it with you. And if people want to just use it, you can just install this indicator and get a sense of it. Now we'll look at a couple other symbols. This is the Russell 2000 IWM, and same thing here. As you can see that when we bottomed back in March, right, this perfect formation hit 9, and after that, in assuming that if you were short in the market, you could basically say, all right, this is not a bad place to take my profits. And since then, the market has traded inside this channel, and now we're getting another sort of sequence that's currently on, right? Since it's smack in the middle of the channel, it's just hard to take a position, right? I prefer taking a position when it is at the extreme end, then the risk reward is actually in your favor. So let's look at one more example. Let's look at Tesla. And you can same thing. You can see here that as we hit the sell formation at 9, and that was really the bottom of the trend for now, and it has reversed. And here again, we start another sequence which went from 1 through 9, and once we were at 9, it did take a little pause, and the market pulled back a little bit. And now again, we're going through this. We're going through two formations, right? This perfect buy formation which goes to 9, and then the array formation is also currently in works, and this is the one that exhausts at 13, right? So now there's a lot of people who've done some historical analysis, and they've said that in the past that when Tesla hits 4 on the buy formation, it typically makes a pretty decent move. And if you look at here, it did make a little bit of a move here. Once you were at 4 here, it did make a pretty decent move, but this case in the downward direction. So hopefully, this is something that you can start using and play around a little bit with it. And this will work on all different time frames, right? So you can use it on the daily chart, the 15-minute, 30. So in other words, when you hit 9 on the 30-minute chart, means the 30-minute chart is basically at a topping formation or close to that. And of course, in many cases, as I said, this sequence could continue once again. So let's just kind of like go over into the on the 15-minute chart, and I want to show you a couple trades that showed up using the Ultimate Trading Technology, UTS, that we use, the Ultimate Trading Signal, and how they ended up doing today. So this is a list that I provide, and this is a dynamic scan, and this is a scan that's comes with the software for people who actually buy the software from me. And this will automatically give you sort of trades with basically a buy signal and a sell signal. And hopefully, once this data loads, we can see if there was a trade that was on. And so this is the trade on the 15-minute chart, right, that happened through this watch list. And this is actually set to day trade. In other words, no matter what, it closes the trade at the end of the day. And if we look at the show report, we'll see. So it was a nice, $297 profit. This trade initiated at 70 at 7:45 a.m. You bought 100 shares, and then you close the trade at 12:45 p.m. For a nice profit, right? And we should be able to see, like, other examples here. Let's look at Burlington as well. Now, as I said, here's a good example where, the sequence ended here at number 9, and got a little bit of a pause, and then it started again. And if we were in this trade as well from the list, we were up another $282. And if you basically count all of it, you probably made about 1,000, 1,500, just kind of trading just the signal using the automated buy and sell. So let's take a look at. I wanted to take a, and this is another signal that came, which worked out well as well. So this one's $71, and this is the total profit in the last month using 100 shares. But we can look at Tesla, which was sort of an interesting trade. I'd call this out in my Discord room as well, that this might actually work out well. And so this actually had two trades today, right? So let's look at the show report. And the first trade made you $595, right? So this is again 5:21, and at 7 a.m. you got a short signal. You shorted 100 shares, and then at 8:45, so in other words, in an hour and 45 minutes, you covered it for a profit of 595. And then at 11:10 a.m. you got a long signal now, which was buying 100 shares at a price of 812, and then you close this at the end of the day, or it automatically closed the trade at the end of the day for a profit of 1650. So it's a little over $2,000 in profit on the Tesla trade. So here's your where it initiated the short signal, and this is a channel that I actually mentioned in my room. I said if it breaks this channel, then it'll be a good short. But we already had the short a little bit earlier, and of course, since it really didn't break the channel, had a reversal, you would anyway be closing the trade back in the channel. So it closed it at a near perfect time. Then a little bit later, as I said, you got another buy signal here, which also gave you a nice profit. So hopefully this little bit of tutorial, this little tutorial helps you out in how to use the DeMarc's sequence. And if you see the numbers 9 and 13, if you on Twitter and people talking about it, you have a little bit of a sense of what it entails. Have a wonderful trading week, a good holiday, and good Memorial Day holiday. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.